Right, Aki Kareem, British boxers. We're over here at Fight Factory in Manchester today. We've got unbeaten Sean Fennell with us, and your teammates are just doing a bit of a workout back there. Yeah. Getting a bit of getting put through the paces today, aren't they?
Yeah. Working hard, always.
I noticed that Paulie and Sean are always keeping a watchful eye on you. There's really nowhere definitely. To hide, is there?
Yeah, definitely. This camp's been good. I've learnt a lot. Been working on a few things from my last fight. Obviously, I'm fighting in 3 weeks on the Black Flash show at the Middleton Arena. So, from my last fight, I've just been working on a bit more volume punching, a bit of defensive movements, a lot of stuff like that, just to put into play in my next fight.
Take me back to your professional debut. Obviously, it was building up for a while. You were deciding whether you were going to turn over or stay amateur. You decided to turn professional. You had your pro debut on a Black Flash show.
Yeah, also.
Tell us about the whole experience.
Well, it was good. My opponent changed within like the first few days, so we prepared for a bit of a different opponent, but it didn't really put us off. We just stick with what we was doing all throughout the camp. But I enjoyed it. It was good. It was a good learning curve because it taught me that nothing's set in stone, just take whatever comes. So that was a good thing, what I picked up from that.
And you got 4 rounds under the belt as well.
Yeah,
so it's
a
good sort of to sort of get those initial nerves out of the way.
Yeah, that's
how did
it.
You feel going into the fight? You know, like the ring walk and everything.
There was a little bit of nerves. It's different. It's different to the amateurs. It's all learning. I was happy with how things went, but I think there's a lot I could improve on. That's one thing I will say.
So you've mentioned the volume punching and your output and that sort of stuff. So,
yeah.
So is it more? Are we going to see on the 15th a bit more output? Is that what
definitely,
you're saying?
Definitely,
In between camps, so from your last fight, in between camps, obviously, I mean, it looks to me like the stable's grown a bit.
Yeah, definitely.
So
we've got a few new lads in, and we're also starting amateurs. So that's one thing that's come through. We've got two new Hungarian lads as well who are turning over. But since the last fight, I had 1 week off at Christmas, and then since then I've been back in the gym all throughout. So I don't really take too much time off. I like to stay active, really.
Yeah,
yeah.
You're very young though, aren't you, still?
Yeah. I'm so still 19.
19, so you've got an absolute age in the game.
Yeah,
that's what you call a young pup in the game.
But
have you been sort of learning from the people around you as well?
Yeah, definitely. Sort of, and also now Paulie's in. It gets a different insight because I've been working with Sean for a while, so I get a little different insight because obviously all coaches do things differently. So it's good to get a little bit of two different styles at the same time. So I'm finding that very beneficial.
Tell us a little bit about your sparring. I know you've always had good like in-house sparring, but I know you guys, you know, we travel for sparring as well, go to different gyms in Manchester.
Well, I've been sparring a little bit with Ben Capps.
Over at
Gary's. And then I've also been doing some good rounds with Bayern, who's a good amateur, over 50 fights. So I've been learning a few different things from there because he's quite tricky. So I've enjoyed that. I've had some good strong rounds in. I've also been sparring a bit with Mauro, who's in-house, of course, so don't have to go anywhere for that. So camp's going very well. I'm looking forward to it. 3 weeks to go.
That's right. So 3 weeks out. Tell us a little bit about sort of how the training regime goes for you. Because obviously you're fresh in the game. You've got loads of enthusiasm.
Yeah.
But I know your coaches as well will be trying to sometimes slowing you down, sometimes speeding
you up.
That's
the thing. The problem with me is resting. I like getting my sessions in. So sometimes Sean has to say, right, calm it down a little bit. It's never an issue of getting the sessions in. I'm always ready, wanting to go again. So usually, for this camp, we've been doing about 3 sparring sessions a week. We've been doing 2 weeks, 3 sparring sessions. And then the following week, we've been correcting what's been going wrong in the sparring sessions, doing like pad work, drills, and then the following week, back into sparring. So that's how it sort of ran. Do you get what I mean?
Tell us a little bit about the Sean Fennell away from boxing then. So when you're forced to do a bit of a rest, like today you're on a rest day.
I can see
you're itching to get in the ring. I can see it.
What
do you do when you're sort of in your spare time?
Well, outside the gym, I'm into my swimming, do a bit of yoga with Sean. Also, I just like seeing friends, going back home, see family occasionally. Do you know what I mean? I'm just a normal teenager apart from boxing, do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Boxing, being an athlete, it's tricky. But apart from that, I'm just a normal young lad, do you know what I'm saying?
Well, a lot of those things involve sort of what they call active rest, so you're always in the zone, aren't you?
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
Yeah. But, I mean, you know, in terms of like a healthy lifestyle, boxing must have given you some quite a lot of, other than just a career and a platform, you know, to wake up and eating healthy and feeling healthy.
Yeah, definitely. A lot of people, if you're in the, like, business, you know it's a way of life. It's not just like, oh, when you're in the gym and then you go and then it's finished. Nah, it's 24/7. Got to constantly be on your mind what you're eating, if your food's ready for the next day. So it's 24/7, yeah, 365.
So to other 19-year-olds who are out there, you know, you've got
very different lifestyle.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Very different lifestyle, yeah.
What would you, I mean, would you recommend to all the youngsters to get involved into boxing yourself then? I mean, obviously,
yeah,
it's like
definitely
a good role model for young lads.
Do you know what it is? Even if you don't want to be champion of the world, even if you don't want to, boxing is a good thing just for fitness, healthy lifestyle. If you want to just get yourself off the streets, do a little something with yourself, spend an hour in your local amateur gym, perfect really, innit?
Yeah, we've started breaking you down to the chill factor.
After my, we're going to go on a little ski holiday, me and Sean.
So Sean's got you down on a toboggan?
Nah, I'm practicing my skiing, so my first
time. That's a great exercise, isn't it?
Yeah.
Movement,
definitely.
And balance. And
I was a little bit shaky at first, but having it.
We want to keep his lifestyle active and keep him doing active stuff, not going on to Ibiza and getting absolutely wasted. Or we want to try and get him doing stuff that is going to keep him active and keep his mindset positive. Keep him doing things that can complement his boxing, including just not being thrown into thinking, okay, right, I'm off, I'm not in camp, and I can just go and get wasted now, you know, get a few drinks or start eating unhealthily and everything else. So yeah.
Keeping him on it, trying
to keep a balance. Boxing does come first, but outside of boxing, you've got to have a normal, life, really, don't you?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, I'm looking forward to your next fight, mate, because I'm going to be commentating on it. So I'll see you up close and personal.
Looking forward to it. Looking forward.
Go on, give me your final shout outs. Give us the like, sponsors that you want to thank and all that sort of stuff.
I just want to say thank you to Société Noire, Spread Eagle, Mella, JR Electricals, and of course Fight Factory, Sean, everyone that's supporting me behind the scenes. Yeah, see you fight night.
All the supporters.
Yeah, and of course all the supporters.
Right, get your tickets to see Sean.
Get your tickets.
15th of March, Middleton Arena. You know the one.
You know.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.